Hello everyone, welcome to Flying Abroad. I hope you all are doing good and keeping safe. So today I have my brother Kamal with me and he is currently doing masters from Germany. So I thought that I will take his interview and share his experience of admission procedure with you all so that you guys can also learn from his experience and gain some knowledge. So yeah, let's start the video. Hello Kamal, welcome to Flying Abroad.
Hello everyone.
So to begin with, let's first understand that what you have done in your masters and what is your background.
Okay, I have done my bachelor's in computer applications. I finished it last year in 2019.
Okay, and did you also gain some work experience in between or directly applied for your masters?
No, I did not do any internship during my bachelor's, but after my bachelor's I worked as a freelancer for a few months.
Okay. And so how you decided or why you decided that you want to do your masters from Germany?
Well, I think the most important reason was the cost of education is like in my university I just need to pay 292 euro per semester, so it's almost free, and with that fees I will get many benefits like free transportation, etc. And other reason was like I don't need to give any special exam like GRE. I just need to give the IELTS exam, it's quite easy. So the application process is really easy. I just need to go to the university website and apply online.
And you can do it by yourself.
Yeah,
majorly.
And that's it. And the requirements are nothing special. They just check the bachelor's degree percentages. And the quality of education in Germany is really good. Germany has the highest rate of Nobel laureates.
Okay, that's news for me.
Okay.
So majorly the quality of education is of course very important, and you thought that the process is easy to apply.
Yeah.
And then the cost was also an important factor that you considered.
Yeah.
Okay.
One major barrier other people consider is the language, but that was not a problem for me. My course is 100% in English, and in fact they did not even check my IELTS score, as my bachelor's course was in English, so that was enough for my university. The visa process for Germany is quite simple compared to countries like USA.
So after you decided that you want to do your master's from Germany, what was the first step that you took and how did you start the process?
I think first of all I applied for the passport, and after I got my passport I applied for the IELTS exam, and once the IELTS exam result came out, I think I had all the documents required for that to start my application process. Then I started searching for the courses online related to my field like computer science, and I came across this website dart.de. It's really a good website. It's like a search engine for all the courses in Germany.
Yeah.
And I created an Excel sheet where I
listed all the
details like fees, when the application date will start, and
what are the subjects,
what are the requirements, whether I meet the requirements. Even if I don't meet the requirements, I wrote that in the Excel sheet, so I don't check the same course multiple times.
Yeah, exactly. You saved your time that way.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's, I think, a very useful tip, that you can also create an Excel sheet so that everything is in place. And then, how did you start the application process? You did it by yourself, by a uni assist, or how you did that?
After I created the Excel sheet, I had in my list like 40 universities, and then out of that I picked like 15 universities whose courses I really liked, and then I did not go through any agent or like that. I just applied directly according to the instructions mentioned on the university websites.
Mm-hmm.
And for some university I just had to apply directly, and for some university I had to apply via UniAssist. UniAssist is basically an organization that helps the
students with the application
with
process.
The application process, it makes
and
it quite simple. And
yeah.
And I also had to send my documents physically via post to some universities, and once to UniAssist.
Okay.
And
you sent your documents only one time to UniAssist, and they use them every time you apply to some university.
Yeah, exactly. I just had to send them one time.
Okay. And what was the cost for UniAssist? And if you send them to each university, what was your cost for each application or for the entire application procedures?
For the first university, I had to pay 75 euro to university, and then it was 30 euro per university. And I don't think any other university charged me money for application if it was not through UniAssist.
Oh, so it was like free for applying.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. That's great.
Yeah, I think one university charged me 50 euro,
okay.
But I don't remember its name.
Okay.
And
Did you also apply in private universities, and how was that?
I have also applied for private universities.
They were also free, the application?
Yeah, the application was free. In fact, it was very fast. After I applied, I got the acceptance letter after 2 days.
I remember you applied in SRH.
Yeah, exactly.
And how did you send your documents to the universities, and how long did it took to reach them?
For one university, the deadline was after 4 days. So I sent them via speed post,
okay.
And it reached the university within 3 days.
Okay.
And the charge was around 2000,
okay,
I think.
2000. Okay.
Yeah. And for other universities, I sent via India Post,
mm-hmm.
Not speed post, not normal.
Normal duration.
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, normal. And the charge was it was very cheap. I think 300-400 rupees only.
Okay, so that makes a difference. That if you start applying early, then you can save some money there. 2000 and 200, there's a huge difference.
Yeah, but it took 2 to 3 weeks to reach.
Okay, so that's a long duration. If you have time, then only you can do that.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. And to apply to universities, what all documents did you prepare? And do you have any tips to share, how to prepare the documents or anything from your side?
I think, first of all, the 10th mark sheet, 12th mark sheet, and the bachelor's degree, bachelor's transcript, CV, IELTS exam, and letter of recommendation and letter of motivation. I think that was it.
Okay, and how did you prepare your letter of recommendation or letter of motivation? Did you refer any website, or you just did it by yourself, or how did you do that?
Yeah, I referred to many websites, and I created a letter of recommendation. I wrote it myself,
mm-hmm.
and just got it signed by the teacher.
Okay, so your university professor said that you write it and we will sign it.
Okay.
And I remember that there was a time when you were also thinking to apply to UK, and I remember that you got an admission also, but then do you have any specific reason why you dropped that option and chose Germany over UK, or it's just you just chose randomly? And
I think there's no strong reason, but first of all, one of the main advantage in UK is the master's is just 1 year.
Okay.
And I think the one of the major drawback is the fees.
Okay.
Because at least the fees is at least 10 lakh per
mm-hmm.
year,
mm-hmm.
Depending on the university. For some university it's even 30 lakhs.
Okay. So the less duration was your factor that you drawn you towards UK, but then the cost factor made you choose your university in Germany.
But still, UK was quite a good option,
mm-hmm.
but at the end I just decided
you found
to
Germany a better option because of the cost factor.
Yeah.
Okay. You did your application procedures and all the documents and everything by yourself, or you did it via any agent? So do you want to share any tips or your experience on that part also?
No, I did not go through any agent. I mostly did everything by myself, but my brother-in-law was there to guide me. And he did not spoon feed me, but he briefed me about the whole process and about
how to do it. So he has also done his master's from there, so with his experience he guided you that how you can do it, and then you did it completely by yourself.
Yeah.
Okay, that's great. And how was your experience with the IELTS exam? Did you have to study a lot, or you would say it was an easy one?
No, I did not study much. I just studied for 1 week, and I was able to score 6.5. It was
I think the minimum requirement is 6 for most universities.
Yeah, for 50% universities, the requirement is 6, and
mm-hmm.
for other 50, it's 6.5.
Okay.
I think 2 universities had a requirement of 7,
mm-hmm.
But they were not much.
Okay. And so, okay, so you have applied your documents and you have sent your documents to universities and application procedure is done. And what is the next step after that?
I just had to wait
okay.
for the result.
And how was your experience with that? Like how long you had to wait and like what is the time duration that universities took to revert you that if you are selected or not? And like how did you get the admission finally?
I think I had to wait for 2 or 3 months. Like I think at least half universities did not even reply whether I got accepted or rejected.
Okay.
Some universities replied that I got rejected,
mm-hmm.
and one university replied that I got accepted.
Okay. So right now you are in which university and what course are you doing?
I'm doing global software development in Fulda University.
And how did you get selected for that? Do you want to share your personal experience?
Yeah, in December I got an email from them.
That December 2019.
Yeah, exactly. That I have to appear for an online exam.
Okay.
It was of 3 hours, I think.
Okay.
Yeah, and the exam was after like 1 week from the email I got.
Okay.
And I appeared for the exam, and within 1 week I got an email from them that I got accepted.
Okay.
And as soon as I was accepted, I started preparing for my visa process.
Okay, but I think that's quite unusual that you had to appear for like exam separately for a university. For most of the universities,
yeah,
that's not the case.
Yeah, I did not hear from any other university that they take any
mm-hmm.
exam.
Okay, yeah. Okay, but any which ways, you got it, so that's good. So you started your semester then in April 2020. So you like basically started in the summer semester.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay, and currently you are doing your classes online.
Yeah.
So that was it about the application process, how he applied and how he got the admission. And I will make more videos with him about where we will talk about like his visa experience and his visa interview and how he got the visa. And also about like the blocked accounts and many other topics, and majorly how he is doing his online classes right now and what is his experience on that also. So for that, keep watching my channel, and yeah, I hope you guys liked this video and you found it like informative and relevant. And yeah, if you have any questions for him, write down in the comments and he will answer them for you. And for more coming videos, please do subscribe to my channel. And for his motivation and my motivation that we keep making such videos, please do like the video. And I will see you in, or I should say, we will see you in our next video. And till then, take care and bye. Take care and bye.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.
Okay, bye.